you adjust the frequency and volume a bit?
Startups, originators, música, cultura, the arts, política, sports, news, technology, crime, tragedy, comedy, lahat ng makabuluhan.
We are your independent podcast content creator, straight from the Philippine Islands.
Mabuhay.
You're listening to Podcast.ph.
Welcome to the 37th episode of Martin's Man Cave. You may listen to us by logging on to Podcast.ph, or you can download us on iTunes. Just type Podcast.ph programs. You can also listen or view us on SoundCloud or YouTube. Just type Podcast.ph. Please follow and like us on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Just type Podcast.ph. My name is Martin Andanar. Our guest today is one of the coolest news anchors of TV5, single, most eligible bachelors in town, was voted as one of the one of the most eligible bachelors who's back in the market by Town and Country Town and Country magazine. Yay! Manu was born on May 3, 1971. His parents are Jose Sandejas and Elenita Sandejas. They are six children. They have six. Jose and Elenita have six children, namely Thomas, Francisco,
Jose Miguel,
Katrina, Anna, Maria, and of course, Manu or Manuel. He was educated at the South Ridge grade school in Parañaque, right? Muntinlupa. And he finished his university degree at the University of Asia in the Pacific, AB Communication Arts. He started his career as an advertiser in 1993 to 1996. He was a copywriter for Lintas Manila. From 1997 to 1999, he moved to basic advertising. And from 2000 to 2006, he was the group head of Lowe Incorporated. And 2006 to 2008, he was the creative director of Asachi and Sachi. Entrepreneur by heart. In 01, he opened EIC, Scooterista magazine, in 2008.
Editor-in-chief, yeah.
Editor-in-chief, yeah. You were an editor and co-owner as well. Yeah. And, EIC, palang sabi ko, banko ba ito? Out of touch.
EIC.
08 to 2012, owner of, and general manager of
Nobby's
Bike Shop. Nobby's Bike Shop. 2010 to 2014, co-owner and founder of Corner 8 Shipping and Handling. He's been hosting for quite some time now, from 2000 to 2005. He co-hosted the digital tour of Studio 23. And from 2010 to present, he's been working with TV5. Co-hosted Astig, Mondo Manu. He is currently a weather presenter also of TV5 and a news anchor. Action sa Umaga right now, he also co-hosts that. And from 2012 to present, Manu has been co-hosting a Travel Time, the TV show at the ABS-CBN News channel. And sa mga hobbies naman, Manu is into biking, mountain biking, adventure motorcycling, trail running, scuba diving, swimming, windsurfing, sailing, trekking, squash, badminton. He is also an environment advocate and number one fan of all his nephews and nieces. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome Manu Sandejas. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, hello. Thank you. You're welcome, and thanks for having me and for inviting me to join you today.
It's always a pleasure to have interesting personalities like you here inside Martin's Man Cave, and we do thank you for taking the time off your busy schedule on television and your other businesses. I always ask this question. Let's begin from where it all started. Let's talk about your parents. Can you tell us more about your father, Jose, and your mother, Elenita.
Yeah, my mm-hmm. my parents. My dad is mm-hmm. actually more commonly known as Lito. Mm-hmm. I guess that's the standard nickname for mm-hmm. the name for Jose in the mm-hmm. Philippines. No, if it's not Pepe or Pepe, it's Lito. Anyway, so my dad is he's essentially a businessman.
Uh-huh.
Education-wise, his background, he's a chemical engineer.
Mm-hmm.
So, and he's an extreme left-brainer, mm-hmm. me. Mm-hmm. So, uh-huh. everything to him is numbers,
structures,
uh-huh. logical, mm-hmm. everything. In fact, if you're having a conversation mm-hmm. with some people or with him,
uh-huh.
You talk about, you know, your trip on the road going to... going home,
uh-huh.
he'll start computing the distance and the time and how much time it took and what the, you know, things like that. Everything is numbers.
Well, galing, no? How much
yeah, he's that kind of guy.
So he's an empirical evidence person.
Yeah,
everything has got to be on data.
Yes, no? But yeah. he's a very very warm man as well, mm-hmm. and you know, there's not a malicious bone in him.
Uh-huh. So your dad is. Is he OC when it comes to those things like traveling with the family? It's got to be on time. Blah blah blah.
I guess maybe in a way he is, uh-huh. but
organizer.
He likes to be busy.
Uh-huh.
He likes mm-hmm. to keep busy. Mm-hmm. He's no spring chicken. Mm-hmm. So traveling now, he's not as active as he used to be.
Mm-hmm.
The schedule. Nowadays when we go, you know, out of town or when we do stuff together as a family, mm-hmm. he's mm-hmm. It's a little more relaxed now as mm-hmm. compared to yes to the years ago when mm-hmm. the schedule was always fully booked. Mm-hmm. You know, there's not a minute wasted. There's always a museum or mm-hmm. a theme park that has to be visited or something. There's always an activity. He's and even his schedule now is still like that. My dad is semi-retired, but he's the kind of man who cannot sit still.
Uh-huh.
And if you look at his calendar for the day, mm-hmm. daily calendar, if you look at that, it's booked wall to wall.
Wow.
And sometimes he even overbooks himself.
Uh-huh.
To the point where he's oftentimes late mm-hmm. for his meetings or his lunches or whatever he has to attend to. He's all often late, and but that's also the thing about my dad. He will uh-huh. always accommodate you.
Mm-hmm. So if your dad is the more structured person,
yeah,
the structured brain, all science and stuff. Where did you get your artistic brain?
The influence came. Yeah, I think the influence came from my mom.
Mm-hmm.
My mother is more of a housewife, but uh-huh. then she has gotten involved with businesses as well
uh-huh.
on her own,
mm-hmm.
and she's also very active in terms of mm-hmm. Her advocacies.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of it would have to do with the Opus Dei
mm-hmm.
and pro-life, mm-hmm. you know,
mm-hmm.
things like that. So mm-hmm. she's very active in that. But the creative aspect mm-hmm. is coming from, she has that in her as well. Mm-hmm. And it's very strong. In fact, she used to do a lot of designing. For...
Mm-hmm.
For ceramics,
uh-huh.
we used to own and operate a ceramics manufacturing business.
Wow!
And she was also very involved with the designing of the products.
Uh-huh.
And she used to paint. She used to draw as
mm-hmm.
well.
Mm-hmm.
So she is an artistic lady.
So your father was an engineer.
He is an engineer, chemical engineering by education.
And your mom.
What did she take? Yeah, honest. I think
in the arts,
economics or something, home economics or something like that. It's not as like engineering or mm-hmm, anything mm-hmm, like that. Mm-hmm. You know, honestly, I can't recall right mm-hmm. now off the top of my head.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, she's a very artistically inclined uh-huh. person.
I noticed that you have a good work ethic. I see you. You're early at work. You got that from your father?
Yeah, I'd like to think, that I got that from both my parents, both of them. They're very diligent when they're with their commitments, whatever it may be, whether it's work or commitment to a certain schedule or to an advocacy, whatever. They're whatever, as long as you commit to something, you stick to it, and you know you've accepted that responsibility, and of course I you know I also get that from back in school. I wasn't as disciplined
in Southridge. It's impossible.
No, yeah, well, you know, that's the thing with Southridge and UANP, because it's so rigid, so you have to be. In a way, they'll watch out. They'll watch you, and they'll crack the whip on you. Yeah. But then, bulakbul pa rin eh. You can still be a slacker, diba?
You know, I'm. You're scaring me because my son is in Southridge, and I love the school.
Yeah,
and I love the way that they have trained him to be a responsible boy, and I see him growing up very responsible.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not the type of parent that looks over his shoulder all the time. Do this, do that. No. I give him space.
Right.
But when I see him fixing his clothes, fixing his room, studying, no, and then he'll be mad. Pag meron kaming lalabas kami, halimbawa, meron kaming family dinner na hindi niya alam.
Right.
Mom, why didn't you tell me I have a homework? I can't go. Sorry. Ganun din ba kayo dati?
Well, you know, I've been out of school for many, many, many years. So things have changed as far as the school is concerned. I can honestly say, and I know for a fact that a lot has changed in the way the school operates.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, the core philosophy of a school like Southridge is this: education begins at home.
Uh-huh.
So I'm telling you that discipline that he has is not coming necessarily from the school. It's coming from you and your wife.
Oh, really?
Yes. And I'm pretty sure that he has it in him to be that way from when he was still in your wife's womb.
Well, maybe
he always had it in him.
Well,
it just got more enhanced or more, I don't know what you'd call it. It became more pronounced in school.
So it's still more caught than taught. And then the teaching is secondary.
Yeah, I think you can say that.
I mean, when you send your daughter or son to a paraf organization or school, you have to be involved all the time.
Yes, education starts at home. So that's, I think he's always had it in him.
I spend time with my kids.
Yeah.
The father-daughter, father-son that the school taught us to apply at home. And that has become a way of life for me. So when you were growing up, was that also a way of life for you and your dad and your mom?
Yes, absolutely. We would do a lot of things together, whether it was, you know, regular daily meals or sports activities and trips together.
Mm-hmm.
It was a big deal. It was always, we would always do stuff together, the family.
I'm very interested because, of course, this is the first time. I mean, my kids are still growing up. And, and I don't know what the effect will be in 20 years or 35.
Yeah, I understand completely.
So I want to ask this question. Has the school contributed to the way or to the relationship that you have with your parents right now?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It helped to instill and strengthen your values as far as the family is concerned. Of course, you know, in the Philippines, it's such a big thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
We all know that family is number one in the Philippines, diba?
Mm-hmm.
But it was further enhanced, I guess, so to speak, by the way the school, the core philosophy of the school, which is precisely that education is first and foremost at home.
Mm-hmm.
And the influence is strongest at home.
Mm-hmm.
Which means, naturally, that the parents are involved and they have to be involved.
Who are you closest to, your father or your mother?
You know, I think I can speak a little better with my dad.
Uh-huh.
because he's so much more open-minded. But again, as I mentioned earlier, he looks at things in a very different way, at least from me. Because, as I mentioned, he's extreme left-brainer. I think in that line of thinking, I'm more right-brainer. So, and then whereas my mother, she is a right-brainer as well, but she's very emotional. She doesn't show it, but she is. She's very hard-nosed, and you know, parang may suot na tapa ojo. You know, she'll stick to her guns. Yeah. This is what I believe in. There's nothing else.
Tigas ulo.
Yeah. Yeah. This is the only way to go.
You know what they say? I mean, if you're a right brain, then naturally you get attracted to the left brain because opposites attract.
Yeah, so that's what they say.
But at the end of the day, they say that you're better off with someone who belongs to that quarter of the brain where you belong to. So if you're a left brain, you should stick it out with the left brain. Because most likely you will have more things in common.
Right. This one, yes. And if you're open-minded enough, you'll be a little more accepting and understanding of each other.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
Yeah. But yeah, so between the two, I understand my mother completely, and I can read her like a book, and I know exactly what she's going to do and what she's going to think.
That's where you're coming from too.
Yeah. So, but I can, if it comes to talking and, and fleshing things out, that's my dad. Yeah.
When you hear the family name Sandejas, especially if you're from the south, right now I'm from the south already, but my wife's family, they've been from the south since time immemorial. And she tells me,
I know where this is headed.
Okay. No, she tells me when you hear the family name Sandejas, when she was in grade school and high school, they would titilian, mas Sandejas yung guwapo yung yun, alam mo yung mga familia dito. Was it always in the south? You guys always lived in the south? O saan pa galing ang pamilya ng Sandejas?
Okay. Lineage, I'm not sure. I think it's my dad's big on family, so he's really, really into his family tree. Yeah, and he has the family tree all plotted out, you know. And he's, you know, family reunions. He's, you know,
Kaling.
If any opportunity he gets, he's going to invite anyone who's a related fifth, sixth, tenth cousin. Ganon type. He's like that. My dad's like that. Yeah. And that's part of his advocacy kasi.
So he traces, so he's into genealogy.
Yeah, I guess you could say that, yeah. So we trace our roots to Pampanga, to the Magdangal clan. Okay, I'm not sure exactly how it works, but that's where it goes. Everything goes back to that.
The Sandejas clan. Yeah. Sandejas from the Magdangal clan.
We're related to Lenora Rivera, things like that. Jolina Magdangal.
Really?
Seriously, yeah. Wow. Yeah, there was a reunion pa nga once where they said when Jolina Magdangal was bigger, no? Her name was more matunog, no? They were seeing their reunion. Ladies and gentlemen, Jolina Magdangal! They were tilian yung mga tao. They were screaming. This old lady comes up on the stage. Apparently, her name was Jolina Magdangal. It wasn't the Jolina Magdangal artista. It was another elderly lady who had the name Jolina Magdangal. But we are apparently, I think, related to the Jolina artista. Yeah. Anyway, so going back, yeah, he's big on that. And yeah, so it's a big deal, the family. So we've a riot, no? But then that's, we didn't, my family per se, we grew up in when I was born, we were living in Makati in Baler Street, I think, or something, I'm not sure. And then we moved to Merville, and then we moved to Alabang, which was in the '77, '78, '79, '80, maybe sabihin natin 1980.
Ayala
79, 79, 80, something like that.
Did you ever imagine that Ayala Alabang will become a republic?
No, not at all. Because, you know, when we moved to Alabang, it was all fields. It was all fields.
Talahiban.
And we used to see snakes. We used to see flying frogs. We used to see owls.
Owls.
I used to bike around with my BMX, with my barkada. And the roads were still not done. A lot of... Kasi, you know, Alabang is huge, right? Alabang is so big that the roads at the time were still not done. And so we used to bike around with the... I used to bike around with my friends in our BMX and explore. And yeah, we used to see all this wildlife. And it's nothing like that now. Nothing like that.
Now it's a republic. Like when I'm saying it's a republic, it's got a polo club, it's got a club, it's got a gasoline station, it has its own grocery, it has its own Starbucks, football field.
That's an accurate description because, you know, my family is all based in the south, in Alabang. Mm-hmm. And I'm the only one who's not there now. And their world is all there. Everything is there.
You can live there.
They live there. They work there. They study there.
You don't have to go out.
They don't. So everything is there for them.
And with all the trees and...
Yeah. I mean...
It's still a bird sanctuary.
Yeah. I love the place. I mean, I like going home to the area, to my folks' place.
You have 5 brothers and sisters.
Yes.
Who are you closest to? And sino naman yung pinaka... Nagka-clash kayo? But before you answer that question and other questions about your college years, let's play one of your favorite songs.
Okay.
Incidentally, Crazy by Seal is also one of my favorites. I used to listen to 99.5 RT and would wait for Vincent Price to introduce this song. Seal, Crazy, 99.5 RT.
Yes.
What makes the song one of your favorite songs?
Well, first of all, I have to give it to the guy. He's a class act.
Genius.
Seal. Mm-hmm. Class act. He's got the soul. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Heidi Klum. He had Heidi Klum. Over and been there, been that. The Heidi Klum. His music. I love his music. Uh-huh. But aside from that, he was introduced to me by my eldest brother.
Oh.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And my eldest brother passed away in 1992.
Oh, really?
So there is that, you know, that sentimental value of the song, so to say, in a way, no? But aside from that, yeah, he's a great artist. I'm really still hoping that he'll come to some country here in Asia and I will go and watch it.
Let's say I'm really hoping.
Yeah.
I'm going with you.
Oh. I've been lucky enough, the closest I've gotten so far is a DVD of his concert in Paris.
Let's watch Seal together.
Solid.
When you go there, let me know.
Yes.
Let's buy the ticket together online.
Now, when I checked online, he was in his tour maybe a year ago or so. He was performing with Macy Gray.
Wow.
He was touring with Macy Gray. Can you imagine Macy Gray. And Seal?
Galing, no?
Ayop.
Let's listen to this song, ladies and gentlemen. Seal and the song called Crazy, one of the top songs back in the 90s. You're still with Manu Sandejas here in Martin's Man Cave on podcast.ph. Don't go away. Enjoy the song. You can never go wrong with Seal and Crazy. Every time I feel down and out, I listen to this music.
Up. Masayap. Sarap siyang pakinggan. Ang galing.
Galing, diba?
Ibang klase siya. Alam mo, mahal ko na siya ngayong si Seal. When I have the DVD of his concert.
You have a man crush on Seal.
I watched his concert sa Paris dun sa DVD nga. And napaka-simple ng setup niya. Guitarist, bassist, drummer, and then him. No backup vocals, nothing. And you could, and syempre there are shots of the audience, di ba? You can see the women going nuts. hindi when I say going nuts, it's not screaming their heads off. Ah. Yung hindi na nila alam ang gagawin nila. Nakatulala na lang.
So, sobrang hot ni...
Yeah.
Ha, and hot ni Jun sa Baiton. Jun, papatay naman yung blower doon.
And even some of the males, you know, were so admiring him. Looking talagang hayop this guy, pare.
Iba talaga. Galing. I have a double CD of... Ang baduy, no? CD.
No, I still collect CDs. Because of the sleeves.
I have the double CD of Seal. The first one is the album where this song came out.
Yeah, the first one. Crazy. Yeah.
And then the other one is...
The one with metaphors. Kiss from a Rose.
Kiss from a Rose. Yes. The Prayer for the Dying.
Dreaming in Metaphors.
Oh, why do we dream in metaphors?
Newborn Child. Things like that.
Fear.
I think I have almost all his CDs.
Earlier, we were talking about your Alabang. No?
Yeah, and living in the South.
So, did you ever expect or imagine that it would become as big as it is right now?
No, uh-huh. Never did, actually. But of course, you know, when you're growing up and, you know, you're just happy to have what's there, and mm-hmm. that was our own little world, mm-hmm. diba? Mm-hmm. And you know, you're young and you're a kid, and you don't look for much else. Uh-huh. And whatever's there is there, and that's it. And me on my own, in my case, I was happy with my bicycle.
Is it the place where you see yourself going back when you retire?
Honestly, maybe not in Alabang itself, but uh-huh. maybe even further south.
Oh, yung mga West Grove,
something like that. Thereabouts, uh-huh. West Grove, quiet, the Santa Elena area.
Dami doon, Santa Elena. Wow,
really beautiful, those places out uh-huh. there. But then, you know, as development and progress continues, mm. eventually, those areas of West Grove and Greenfield, mm-hmm. it's going to be what Alabang is mm-hmm. now. Tuloy-tuloy lang yan, uh-huh. just keep going out.
Okay, let's talked about Southridge and studying there, grade school, high school. Let's talk about your university years. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of people know that you went to University of the Philippines before you transferred to UANP. No?
Right, which was CRC at the time.
CRC.
So I went to, out of high school, I went to UP Diliman for a year, mm-hmm. for 1 year. Mm-hmm. And believe it or not, I was in applied physics.
Talino mo, boy?
No. Huwag kayo masyado mabilib. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Dahil, first of all, non-quota course yan.
Because not a lot of people, students would like apply to get into physics.
Yeah. It's not a popular sport.
I mean, during that time, during our time, it was what? About...
Engineering.
Nursing. Alam mo, nung panahon later natin, di ba, una, I remember it was, what was the in thing before our generation? Med tech. People wanted to be a medical technician mm-hmm. because they wanted to also sell medicines, etc. Yeah. And then after that, it became nurses. Ito yung pangkaraniwang pangmasa na courses.
Yeah.
So during, when you applied in UP,
you
applied... Is it possible hindi siya... At sabagay, hindi nga siya...
It's a non-quota.
Non-quota.
Oh, really? It was.
I think si...
Was my second choice.
Si Atom Araulio is also physics, if I'm not mistaken.
Ah, no. Atom is a very intelligent guy. Uh-huh. Hmm. He's very intelligent.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Atom is very intelligent. No
Philippine
doubt.
Philippine Science High School.
Yeah. Matalinong bata yan. Uh-huh. Matalino talaga yan. Hmm. But that wasn't... You know, now, looking back, it's not... That wasn't my... I didn't apply for on my own.
So you went to UP.
Yeah, UP Diliman.
You're at the top, the premier public university in the Philippines. You're the Ivy, the public Ivy League of the Philippines.
And
what made you decide to move out and go to CRC?
Well, that's the thing that we were talking about uh-huh. when it comes to the needing a school like Southridge and the rigid and the discipline and the cracking of the whip if you don't do your homework, right? at that time, I was so kalat. You know, if I stayed in UP, I would have overstayed.
Uh-huh. Kalat.
Yung no discipline.
Uh-huh.
You know, hang out with the guys, go out with meet girls and all that.
I've talked to a lot of parents of Southridge, and going back to high school again, and they say that one of the reasons why that, sabi nila, dapat hindi ko na pinala sa Southridge, dapat pinadala ko sa Ateneo, ganun-ganun, was because even if the students are really disciplined, nagwawala sila pagdating ng college.
Yes.
Because it's so strict, strict to conformity.
Repressed. It's repression. Mm-hmm. It's of course, it's not true for everyone, no. But then generally, there's some there are cases where that happens.
I should move my son.
Well, that's like again. I go back to what I said about it has to start at home.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be involved, mm-hmm. and you have to be the stronger influence, mm-hmm. and not allow the school and the barkada in school or wherever the barkada is coming from to take over.
Uh-huh.
And to be the strongest influence, the family still has to be the strongest influence.
Uh-huh. So you went to UP, kalat ka, and then you moved to CRC.
Yeah, I said, you know, first of all, this I don't like this course. Mm. It's not the course that I wanted. Mm. It's the course that my dad was influencing me to take,
science again
to apply. Mm. Yeah. That was one.
Mm.
The second one, yun na nga. If I stayed in UP, I would have overstayed, like Roxley.
Mm-hmm.
Next
overstay yun, di ba? It's the understatement of the
year. Oh, there you go. Understatement. Di ba? Nakatambay sa live. So, you know, I would have overstayed. Uh-huh. And talagang... Kasi UP... Well, at least at the time, no?
Uh-huh.
I don't know now. UP, at the time, it's hard to get in, but it's easy to stay in.
Uh-huh.
Once you're in. So I took it upon myself... I gotta leave.
So you moved to
UNP. CRC at the time.
For the sake of our viewers, right? Our viewers and our listeners. So you moved to UANP.
Yes.
And it's a connection of...
It's a familiar system. It was familiar a familiar system for me. I knew that it would be more rigid.
So you needed that.
I needed that at the time. At the time. I needed to be watched like a hawk.
Okay, so after that, you graduated happily?
I finished.
You finished?
I wouldn't say graduated happily. I finished.
I got my degree.
Undergrad degree.
And then you got into advertising.
And then, yes. You know, even if I was in that school, I was still bulakbol. Can you imagine? I was done. I was in the batch that should have marched in 1993.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I was working already in 1993, but I still had my sabit pa rin ako sa school. I had one subject pending.
Saan ang mga gimmick
and
mo?
It was Spanish, for Christ.
Oh, Spanish?
Yeah. Jeez.
Your father speaks Spanish?
My parents used to, not so fluently, but they would speak it. Especially when they didn't want. When you say our last name, it doesn't mean that we're Castilla or anything really na of that sort that, you know... Uh-huh. Second language is Spanish. No?
Yeah, but you've got the Spanish beard.
A little bit. Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's the thing with Asians. No? The thing with Asians, like, for example, Lourdes de Vera and June Sabayton and myself, you know, we don't have a full beard, you know. And with you,
it's a little fuller. It's not full, but it's a little fuller.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
So Gillette will be making money out of you.
Yeah, a little, yeah. Uh-huh. But yeah, it's, my parents used to speak it. Mm-hmm. When we were much younger,
mm-hmm.
but mainly when mm-hmm. they would not want us to understand what they're talking about.
During those times, of course, you finished and you got into advertising already.
Yes, straight out of school, I was actually technically not yet done with school. I was already working advertising.
That's where you wanted to go, advertising.
It was a creative job.
Uh-huh.
It really interested me. I've always enjoyed writing
mm-hmm.
and reading.
Did you get into modeling? I mean, you're tall and good looking.
No. My my parents, especially my mom, during the time,
modeling was the in thing. Like Paolo Bediones, he got into modeling and all of these tall guys. And I didn't get into modeling.
Yeah.
So, but was there an offer for you to be a model?
A ramp model? No hard offers, I think. My mom would always block it.
No hard offers.
Hard offers.
Your yeah. mom would always block it.
Yeah, my mom was. My mom is very like, traditional in that sense. Mm-hmm. You know, if this is the work, kind of work that you should do. None of this entertainment or modeling is.
Where would you hang out during those times?
Malabang. In friends' houses.
Talaga?
Dun lang. Wow. In high school, ah. In college.
No college,
syempre,
yeah.
In college, lumawak na yung mundo namin, di ba? Uh-huh. So, we had a car na, di ba? I could drive myself already.
Wow.
So, a little more freedom. And the school was not nowhere near the home. So, you're exposed to so much more.
Uh-huh.
And that's actually where I'm grateful for my UP exposure.
So when during those times when it was just a dream for me, for June, and for Lourdes to go to Faces, that was your staple.
Actually, hindi rin, because my parents were very strict.
Uh-huh.
And especially my mom. Uh-huh. Again, I go back to my mom.
Uh-huh.
They would limit how much I could go out.
Did you ever go through the age where you smoked, you drank a lot, and
I was a late bloomer in that aspect, in that sense. But then I had classmates who were smokers and drinkers already.
How many girlfriends
even in high school?
How many girlfriends did you have before you?
Reaction in the peanut gallery.
How many girlfriends did you have? Serious girlfriends did you have before you met your ex-wife? But before you answer that question, let's play one of your
maybe that's when you should have played the crazy song.
Sweet Child of Mine.
Oh.
No. That's not yet. That Sweet Child of Mine is a favorite of Mayor Herbert Bautista.
Okay.
I just saw that now. Wow, since we have the radioactive Sago frontman here.
Yes.
In our studio.
One of my favorites is
Radioactive. Radioactive by Kings of Leon.
That's right.
Let's listen to this. What makes this Radioactive one of your favorite songs?
Actually, no real reason. I just came across the band and several years ago, and I really just enjoy their music and their rock and roll lifestyle. And so I have pretty much all their albums so far. I have the DVD of their it's like a documentary on them.
Radio, Kings of Leon. In fact, ano mo idol yung Kings of Leon, idols of startup bands, because apparently this band went around the United States, went to UK, went around for years and years.
They became popular in the UK.
Yeah. I read the story. What the strategy was, or I don't know if that was a strategy back then, but what happened was they started to create a cult following before they became big mainstream. No? So sabi, so kaya idol sila ng mga banda na matagal sumisikat.
Yeah.
But you know, fantastic band.
Yeah,
Kings of Leon, Radioactive. We are still with Manu Sandejas, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with him as well. Let's listen to this song, one of his favorites, Radioactive, here on podcast.ph inside Martin's Man Cave. The music of Kings of Leon, Radioactive. Powerful.
Yeah.
Galing.
Can really feel the band and the guys really getting into it. You watch them on, well, again, like Seal, I've only seen them perform in a DVD.
Mm-hmm.
And you can really feel the alcohol of these guys.
Well,
nakasuminom to.
I like the the song Sex on Fire.
Diba? Yeah, they have a lot of good tunes.
Okay, so the question earlier was
about school.
Serious girlfriends.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, the serious girlfriends. Oh, wow. You know, a lot of things have happened since the ex-wife became the ex-wife. And so because of all of that, you know, a lot of those things in the past are... Mm. And I know it's going to sound like BS to a lot of people, but it's so much of it is a blur already, honestly, really. And if I was to sit down and really think about it, I mean, no offense to anybody, especially the women involved. No offense to anybody. It's a blur. Mm-hmm. It's a blur.
But isn't it a blur for most of the people who get separated or divorced? I mean, they just move on, right?
Depends where you are in, I guess, depends on where you, because past is past, right? And then you move on and you have, depends on how you move on. Eh?
How many serious? I think,
the girlfriends?
Serious ones.
Girlfriends. Maybe five, I don't know.
Before you got married.
Yeah, maybe five, something like that. Woo! It's not talking to you.
before you got married to the person who sang this, you know.
Yun lang.
let's let the peanut gallery hear the music.
Got a letter in the mail today. I'm glad you're doing.
It's a blur.
No. Okay.
I may be saying that these things in the past are it's a blur, but it's part of your life, di ba?
But dude,
these things happen.
Dude, Agot Isidro was the crush of the entire nation.
Mm-hmm.
No, she sang every day and all of it, and then she was coming out of. The show of the Apo Hiking Society. If I'm not mistaken, di ba lumabas sa linggo na po sila?
Yeah, she was part of that.
She was part of that, and
among the hosts in that show. Yeah, she was. With Apo.
Yeah, she was the hottest singer
with Chang Amay.
The hottest singer actress that there could be during that time.
And yeah.
You just stole her heart during that time. What year was that?
We met in around 98, something like that.
Uh-huh.
And then our wedding was in 2000.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not going to ask you how it turned sour or everything. I mean, people have their own stories, di ba?
Yeah.
Let's just put it
if
this
way. If you ask
way.
Me mine, I'll ask you yours, because I'm sure you know.
let's just put it this way.
Oh.
Complete incompatibility. Yun lang naman yan, di ba? For a lot of people, that's the safest thing. But, But people still want to know.
Want to know what?
Want to know about...
It just didn't work out.
Exactly.
And, you know, you come to a point when you realize that you're headed in different directions.
But how's that? Coming from a very conservative family and your mom being very conservative. How did they take this?
Oh, very hard. Uh-huh. Very hard. Mm-hmm. Very hard. Because... as you said, it's a very conservative family that I come from, mm-hmm. and as such,
mm-hmm.
instances like this, you know, don't happen. I mm-hmm. could not imagine it happening.
Yeah,
and it did, and it's the first in our family.
And so. as a guy near your age, mm-hmm. we were one of those couples who were looking up to you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Diba?
Yeah.
Ganun lang yan eh.
Yeah. Mm. Well, yun, it was very difficult. And rightly so. I mean, for anybody, whether it's the family, whether it's friends or people in the fringes who mm-hmm. just are looking up, as mm-hmm. you said, no?
Mm-hmm.
And especially, of course, for the couple involved.
Yeah.
It's painful, it's difficult, it sucks. But it's a process that you have to go through, and you don't have a choice. And because it's something you have to go through,
mm-hmm.
you either sink or you swim.
And what makes it more complicated is because both of you are in the limelight.
Yeah, in a way, but very controlled.
Controlled, yes.
Very controlled limelight, because you have to admit, as you said, people want to know precisely because we... both are very private people. And
but that's the thing. That's why people wanted to know, because both of you love your private lives.
Yes, very. Diba? We cling to it like for dear life, because you know, work is work.
Uh-huh.
Work is work, and this is all we want. You know, work, and we're not here peddling our lives.
Uh-huh. How did recently this week? You know, this show is supposed to be timeless, or it's supposed to be not time bound. But this week we had a story about your ex-wife, na dugo-dugugang.
Yes, you know, someone very unfortunate incident.
And I couldn't help but notice you there sitting down, and while Lourdes and I were reading the headlines na Ago de Sidro na dugo-dugugang ng 3 million piso, blah, 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 blah. What were you thinking during that time? I'm sure you were thinking about something.
You know, I've become detached enough to just say to myself, it's unfortunate that it happened. It has nothing to do with me. So,
but you're in the news. You're influential.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm not in the showbiz news, so I'm not expected. I'm not expected to give my opinion on the matter, nor my sentiments. Mm. Right. Which is why nothing has come out from my end, because I'm not involved. It's none of my business.
Talagang,
it's none of my business.
Talagang dugong bughaw ka, Mr. Sandejas.
I know my place.
You know your place.
I know my place. And respect na lang, di ba? Yes, it's sad. It's unfortunate. It's a lousy thing that happened. Nobody wants something like that to happen. Whether it's somebody who was your ex-wife or a stranger, you know, we see news items like that every morning, Monday to Friday. Mm. And we are always affected, and we always feel bad for the people who are victims, diba? Right? It just so happened that it's closer to home. But, you know, like I said, it's not my business.
We don't normally do this inside Martin's Man Cave and on podcast.ph, but we have a phone-in question.
Okay.
what is the phone in question?
We
we have a caller from the
wrong
line.
Number. Yeah, na.
Ay, mga tol, wala tong signal tong cellphone ko.
Ito, may signal ako. Meron ako.
Lumapit na lang kayo dito.
Ito, meron lang ako.
Ayun.
No,
okay.
Ayaw pumasok. Well, you know, this is one of those programs that you just closed the entire thing officially on podcast. I'm sure you've closed this on broadcast, but no. Like this, that chapter of your life. So,
yeah.
So people stop asking already, you know?
And I guess precisely because we are known to be very private people, people don't ask. They
respect your privacy.
It's out of respect or out of fear. Whatever it is, they don't ask. And we're totally fine with that.
So, pwede magtanong,
sir.
Oo naman.
O, hindi, magtanong ka. May microphone dyan.
Pero, ang sagot doon, hindi ko lang alam kung sasagutin ko yung
tanong. For the listeners, we have June Sabayton.
June Sabayton.
June, what's your question?
My number one bayaw.
Kung fear of respect.
Yes. So,
kasi... Ano sa respect na lang.
Yeah. Because there are people, like for example, there are people in the showbiz industry. Okay, again... Disclaimer, no offense to anyone, okay? There are people kasi in the industry who put it out there, who put their lives out there and make it available to the public, and who live off that and thrive off that and want everybody to know every time they break wind or every time they go to the mall, every single act that they do, they want everyone to know. But then, on the other end of that spectrum, there are people naman who guard their privacy and are only there for the work, right? And those kinds of people, alam ng viewing public, alam ng fans, they can tell that those kinds of people want to be respected that way. Not to say that the people who put out their lives and all that are disrespectful.
A lot of men have a man crush on you, and a lot of women also have a crush on you. I am just... curious why you came in the broadcast world or in the limelight at a later stage of your life, wherein you could have just come in when you were in your early 20s or when you were with Agot or whatever, and you would have been more popular today as but
how did the events transpire?
No, not only that, no, parang why didn't you decide to be on television
earlier? Well, that was because I think if I may speak freely and without offending my parents, no, because they were still able to influence my decisions a little more before, and for them, kasi they're a little more traditional in terms of what kind of work you can get into, what kind of how they look at television work, advertising work, any other kind of work which is alien to them. Mm-hmm. It's not because they look down on it. It's just because it's not familiar to them. It's just because they don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. And naturally, if you don't know what something is, siyempre, you want to protect your child, di ba? Mm-hmm. You want to give them what you know. Mm-hmm. Diba? You want them to get into something that you're familiar with, mm-hmm. and not with something na ano ba yan? We don't know that. Mm-hmm. Wag na yan. Diba? So, you know, it came in later on in my life because it came into my life at a point where I was already really making decisions on my own, talaga. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Really. And it started out maybe in college. Uh-huh. And one milestone for me is, you know, the decision to leave UP and go to CRC. Uh-huh. I did that on my own.
That was your own decision.
My own decision. I said, even if it's a school that I know is, you know, something that still they would really be pleased about.
It's the Ivy League of our...
Ivy League, it has strong Opus Dei influence. Mm-hmm. So it would naturally be okay with them, my parents. Mm-hmm. But even then, even if I knew that, it was still my decision. I was someone that said, on my own, mm-hmm. I'm moving. Mm-hmm. And the choice, of course, was my choice. Mm-hmm. I just went to my parents. I'm moving schools. Give me the check for the tuition.
Mm-hmm. How's life now?
Now it's simple, simpler. Mm-hmm. It's simpler. It's quiet. It's exciting because of the work that we do.
Uh-huh. And you're still into your biking.
I still do. Everything I do, I enjoy. Mm-hmm. And I wake up every day with a big smile, with extreme gratitude.
What is that one thing that you do right now that makes everything just a sad day become a happy day? Nah. Like for example, in my case, this what I'm doing right now.
Yeah.
If I'm in a bad mood or whatever, and if I have a guest like you or anyone, and I'm doing this podcast, that just brings a smile on my face. I'm just happy, you know, those things. What is that one thing?
Off the top of my head, it would be spending time with my loved ones. Being with my loved ones, meaning my family, especially the kids, and of course my girlfriend at this time. Yeah, my girlfriend.
Now, I mean, you've been out with her. You've been out with her and tweeting. Angel.
Yeah, Angel ako. We've been seeing each other for a couple of years now.
Yeah.
It's wonderful. It's great. It's because I think it is where it is, and it is the way it is because we have come into each other's lives when, you know. Mm-hmm. Well, one, I'm not going to say that the timing is perfect and all that. It's just that the timing works for us. And, you know, we're at a place where we're more open-minded, we're more accepting and understanding, et cetera, et cetera. Many things have happened in our respective lives that have, in a way, quote-unquote, formed us.
She's a right brain.
Yeah, she is.
I knew it.
she is more right brain than she is left brain.
Yeah. I think. Because you were saying earlier, na, you're closer to your dad because, he's left brain, but you're closer to him. But it's opposites attract. At the end of the day, you still have to end up with someone who belongs to the side of the brain where you belong.
Yeah. And going back to my parents, I would still say yes, that my mother, although we bump heads constantly, there is that unbreakable bond pa rin. Mas solid yun.
So your mom and Angel, they get along?
I don't know if I wouldn't. I don't know if I could say.
Do you see yourself getting married again, or is it something that you know, I made a mistake before, I'm not going back to that same mistake?
I don't know. You know, things. It's hard to talk about definite things happening in the future because you'll never know it. Yeah, I just deal with everything as the day comes.
What makes you a cool person?
Well, you know, I'm not a competitive person. Okay, I'm sure you guys have observed that as well in the way I operate. I'm not the type of guy who will go upstairs and say, I want to do this, I want to do that, I can do this, I can do that. I'm not like that. I know my worth, my self-worth. I'm grateful for the opportunities that are here. If there are challenges, I'll deal with it as best as I can.
Okay, let's get into the slumbo questions.
Yeah.
Favorite color?
Green.
Green?
Yeah. I love green. I don't know. It's always been green since I was a kid.
It's not related to the school or whatever.
No, has nothing to do with schools. Has nothing to do with...
It's a Mondo Manu, the environmental show.
Environment, yeah. Maybe now because of that. Because, you know, every time where I'm out, whether it's on the motorcycle or on the bicycle, I feel at peace with the greenery and out in the sea as well. You know, it's the best. What's That's the favorite? Best feeling.
What's your favorite movie?
Oh, wow. I like Bucket List. Comes to mind now.
Oh, Bucket List.
Yeah.
So what is in your bucket list that you haven't done?
I really want to do more trips, local trips, domestic trips. And not because of work. I want to do it on my own, you know, whether it's with my better half or alone. I
vegan.
Like vegan. Yeah, I've been to vegan a few times already, and beautiful. I mean, the country, the Philippines is the most... I mean, I can't say that I've traveled the world. I have traveled a bit, and I've seen a lot.
You've been to the different continents.
Yeah, I've been to several. I wouldn't say to all, but I've been to many. But I'd still say I'll always come back to the Philippines.
Philippines, pa rin,
yeah, siyempre. Always come back. The most beautiful.
Do you have any favorite quote?
I have a lot of quotes. Ones that come to mind. If you can't be good at it. Coming from our friends June and Lourdes in one of our conversations recently. The saying of... mas madali hulihin ang manok na nakatali.
I love that.
Okay. What else? I don't know. I can't think of any at this time. Attitude of gratitude.
Attitude of gratitude.
Yeah. Love that. You, if you hold on to that and you just make sure you have that, there's always something to be grateful for. There's always something to be grateful for.
If there are five people who you are grateful to, who are these five people?
My eldest brother, Tom, who passed away in 1992.
He passed away?
In a car accident.
My goodness.
Yeah.
Tragic.
It was tragic, yes.
How old was he?
29, about 29, something like
that. My goodness.
Yeah.
My goodness.
Married with one son. Who's now
a
grown man.
My God.
Yeah, very tragic.
I can't even imagine.
Yeah.
And that son is like your son too.
In a way, yeah. Yeah, in a way.
What is it about Thomas that you cannot forget?
Well, he was very fair in... amongst us siblings, he was the most fair and he was the most supportive of me, I guess, in a way. Because even early on, I was always, you know, I have three holes in my left ear and one on my right ear. Mm-hmm. Okay, I've got a few drawings of, I have some ink on me.
Tattoo.
And I have some tattoos. And, you know, early on, when all of this was already starting, this this capacity or the interest in funky hairdos and earrings and fashion that's different in a way. Mm. He was the one that was a little more supportive and a little more understanding. Mm. And then in a family of siblings, there's always going to be a bully, and there's always going to be the one that's bullied, diba? Right? I was the bullied kid. I was the one that got picked on a lot.
The middle child.
Yeah, I got picked on a lot. I got picked on a lot. And Tom, my eldest brother, was the one that they always defended me.
So Tom, that's one.
Yes.
Second one.
Second one, of course, my parents.
Two
of them. So that's three. Uh-huh. And then...
Well, you can consider them as just one.
Okay.
Because that's two.
So my parents.
So you have three more.
Tom, my parents. Angel.
Angel. Three?
Yeah.
And then, why Angel?
She brings a lot of sunshine into my life.
Oh.
Yeah, she does. Seriously. Mm. Seriously. Very positive person. Mm-hmm. Very positive, very understanding.
When I see Angel, and for some reason I see her all the time, what reminds me is the namaste, sort of like she's like a yoga instructor.
Yeah,
parang it's all positive. All positive, no?
Yeah.
No?
See, I mean, you know, you like I said. We've come into each other's lives at a point where all the experiences that we've been through, that we've undergone in the past, of course, no, have shaped us respectively, separately, as on our own, her life and my life, you know.
So your stars have aligned, no?
Parang, I guess in a way you can say that. So it's quite hopeful.
Okay, so Angel. That's three. Three, four.
And then...
The fourth one.
My three other siblings.
Uh-huh, okay.
So that could be a fourth. Mm-hmm. As one,
you can
I mean, I love them dearly. I love them dearly, and their respective kids.
Oh, your nephews and your nieces.
Yeah, they're the gems. They're the gems.
You were telling me before that you would travel everyone, all of you guys together, and
In general, I love kids. So you can imagine how much I enjoy being around my nephews and nieces. Mm-hmm. It's the best.
And the last question that I ask you is that. No, actually, second to the last question is that medyo anticlimactic to, pero
go.
ano ang paboritong ulam o pagkain ng mga Sandejas or your favorite food? Kasi Pasko na ngayon, di ba? Yeah. Right, Christmas season.
Yeah, you know what? It's tinola.
Tinola manok? Or,
And it has nothing to do with the Christmas season.
Tinola.
It's tinola for me,
Sabaw, huh?
Yeah, and I get that from my dad. My dad loves tinola. He can have tinola every day.
Oh, tinola of manok, native manok, or any manok.
Yeah, well, any. But native is the best.
Native is the best. Yeah. How do you celebrate your Christmas, by the way?
New Year's Eve at my parents' house. We're all together. And then my mom's side comes to the house of my parents.
Christmas Eve. Oh, okay.
So my mom's side, the San Agustin family, they come to my mom's house, to my dad's house. So Noche Buena.
Okay.
Okay. So that's till midnight, till past midnight, and then kanya-kanya na. And then Christmas Day.
Day.
My dad's side.
Sandeja side.
Goes again to my dad's house for lunch.
Wow.
Which carries on until...
So masaya.
Yeah, it's magulo. And I mean, of course, now everyone has their kids as well, di ba? So ang daming bata. And of course, they are all performing. They're all singing and dance and games. It's fun. It's a lot of fun. And I love seeing all my cousins and my nephews and nieces being around them. And most of all, my uncles and my titos and titas. I love catching up. We don't see each other much. But when we do, I love sitting down with them as much as I can. I love sitting down with them and chatting with them and catching up and small talk, you know. It's the quality small talk. It's none of the club small talks.
You're a well-educated person. You come from a very good family. the last question is, because you also mentioned that you've traveled around the world and there's no place like the Philippines. What is your dream for the Filipino?
The Filipino. Wow. Well, for one, we're talking about traveling, tourism. Uh-huh. I really wish that they would really maximize tourism, because I honestly think with the exposure that I have been, what the exposure that I've been
given,
that it is one of the best tools for us for things to improve. Mm-hmm. You know, income generation, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, jobs generation, etc., mm-hmm, etc. Mm-hmm. I really wish that the country would be a little less distracted with self-serving, you know,
politics, the shape up.
Yeah, but unfortunately, I mean, it's not likely to happen in our lifetime. Uh-huh. But hope, you know, everything starts in little steps, uh-huh, one at a time, one foot in front of the next. Mm. Tourism, yeah, and again, you know, we love our freedom, but I don't think we're disciplined enough to handle it. Mm-hmm. Democracy doesn't work with the Philippines.
But no. How do you feel? You're a well-traveled person. Mm-hmm. I've traveled also. Mm-hmm. How do you feel when you see your countrymen flying with you? You're flying and for leisure, and you see countrymen flying for work.
The OFWs, yes, our heroes.
I am devastated when I see.
Yeah.
Our countrymen,
seek opportunity elsewhere. No,
yeah,
yeah, it's very sad, but you know, I'm also a realist, and I will, uh-huh, always accept reality and, uh-huh, deal with it, mm, rather than harp on the tragedy of it all. Mm-hmm. And that's the way it is here at this point. Eh. Mm-hmm. Ganun talaga. Eh. Mm. The opportunity, there's greater opportunity elsewhere.
Abroad, yeah.
Go seek it, diba? Milk it. It has its downsides, obviously. I mean, in terms of, I mean, we go back to the family. Mm-hmm. You've got repercussions on the family, right?
Yes, yes, yeah.
If you separate the dad from his family, you separate the mom from the family, the kids. Those are the sad realities, mm-hmm, of this situation that we're faced with. Mm-hmm. But you know how the Pinoys are. They will always smile at
resilient.
All this adversity, diba? Right? Oh. And very resilient.
Thank you so much for your
thank
time.
Thank you for having me. You're welcome, and thank you. Enjoy.
So we'll have enjoy. That. No, we'll have that podcast show.
Which one? The bicycling or the food?
Both.
All of the above. Love it. Yeah, this is a great opportunity.
Manu Sandejas, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, we have to thank you, but now you're part of Podcast.ph.
Happy to be here.
Yeah. Thank you so much for sharing with us your story. Just Like Heaven by The Cure. This is one of your favorite songs. What makes this one of your favorite songs?
I like the other bands, like the others, like Seal, you know, I just really enjoy the music of The Cure. Robert Smith, what a guy.
Parang solid dadon, yan. Parang dadon.
Yeah. Yeah. Ibang klase si Robert Smith.
Robert Smith.
Galingin. Galingin.
Just Like Heaven. Thank you so much, Manu. Mabuhay ka, sir.
Thank you. Thanks again. Thank you again. Thanks, guys.
The Cure, Just Like Heaven. You're inside Martin's Man Cave here in podcast.ph. We'll see you soon. Thank you so much for joining.
This podcast.ph presentation is supported by Martin Andanar's Homecast Studio and audio.ph.